strange but true. We've told you about this company before. It's called Comptronic, and they produce devices to help your brain. But now their research has just been published. The company uses a technique they call audiovisual entrainment to help speed up brain waves. President Dave Siever says their findings show entrainment helps teens with attention deficit hyperactivity disorder by treating the brain like a tuning fork.
Entrainment with the brain is a similar idea. The brain will respond to a certain number of frequencies in terms of flashing lights or pulsing tones. So when we drive the brain with these stimuli of lights or tones, that energy gets routed through a part of the brain called the thalamus, and the whole brain starts to resonate at different frequencies as we control them by the lights and sounds.
Their study is found in the Journal of Neurotherapy, and the company hopes to bring their entrainment technique into the school system to help students with ADHD.
These students at Britannia Junior High in West Edmonton started using the device last month. They all suffer from attention deficit disorder. The hope is to stimulate their brain so they can focus on their own without having to take drugs like Ritalin.
This could explode into a huge business and a huge technology, overtaking a lot of the pharmaceutical treatments that are in place now.
The University of Alberta Psychology Department helped design the study. Teachers and parents will be monitoring the kids, watching for any improvements in their attention span and their grades. If the kids improve, it could lead to a formal trial. According to this U of A professor, it could also help scientists better understand what causes attention deficit disorder in the first place.
One of the very interesting things that's happening today in the whole area of mental health is we're realizing that contextual conditions, that means the environment, and that includes the social environment as well as the physical environment, are extremely important in the manifestation of psychiatric and psychological pathological symptoms.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Your City. I'm Paul Menier. Getting inside the mind, it is our first topic tonight, and one that even in this very modern age presents perplexing questions. If you know someone with attention deficit disorder, you might be interested to know about flashing goggles. Now, the device has been around for a while, but City TV's Sudhakrishnan tells us the technology is getting new attention.
They look like fun. They sound like fun.
Okay, Gracie. How you doing?
And for 10-year-old Grace Thornton, these goggles are not only just fun, they also help her relax.
Here
we go. Yeah, I'm sleeping a lot better.
This is the David PAL.
David stands for Digital Audio Visual Integration Device. PALed with some flashy goggles, it stimulates brain activity. The technology has been around for decades, but it's this Edmonton-based company that's been designing the devices.
And I originally designed this technology back in 1984 to help performing arts students at the University of Alberta go through, overcome stage fright.
And it now helps people with attention deficit disorder.
It calms down their hyperactive behavior, their impulsiveness, their blurting out in class.
The claim is that the goggles can do a better job than the pills. So how does it work?
What we're looking at here, the pink stuff, it shows all her bad or her slow brainwave activity.
This is a picture of the brain activity of a 22-year-old woman with ADD. The flashing lights and tones reduce what causes the slow brain activity.
And she was able to read here now three or four pages before she started to fog, whereas in the previous shot she was only reading a paragraph or two. That's a big breakthrough for us, that the mainstream medical doctors, who would normally would see this as real quackery, are taking significant interest.
Breakthrough for Mind Alive, but here in our city, the Capital Health Region isn't using the device. And if you click on to the Mind Alive website, it clearly says that the product's not recognized as a treatment or cure for any medical condition or disability. But research suggests the devices are effective relaxation and meditation tools that are making waves in the U.S.
After about 15 years of hard work, on the research side, since 1988, really, we're starting to really catch on now.
In fact, researchers in schools in the U.S. have participated in dozens of studies that show significant improvement in children with ADD. Mind Alive sells about 3,000 of the $300 devices a year, mainly to clinicians. Young people like Grace hope the tool will grab the attention of doctors here, too.
I thought it was like really cool and stuff and fun to use.
Seaver just came back from Holland. He was speaking to therapists there about the device. In November, he will be lecturing at the American College for the Advancement of Medicine in Palm Springs. For more on David Powell, you can log on to our website at citytv.com. Now, Dr. Horst Mueller is one registered psychologist in our city who uses the flashing relaxation goggles to help patients with ADD. Suda visited him at the Miramas Health Clinic.
Dr. Mueller, how long have you been using the David Powell for patients with ADD or ADHD?
I've been using it in my practice for probably about a good 12 years now.
And how has it been working?
I've been finding it's pretty effective. I use it as an adjunctive treatment, so they use it at home while they're doing biofeedback here in the clinic. And I'm finding it really helps get faster results and lowers the cost a lot for the parents.
And why does it cost less for the parents?
Well, they're spending less time in the clinic.
Now, how does this treatment compare to traditional treatment of, like, popping pills like Ritalin or Adderall?
There's evidence that it might be more of a cure for ADD than the medication. The medication changes the brain as long as you're on the medication. But when you go off, you're back to where you were before.
At this point, nobody from Capital Health is using the device, and some people have been a little hesitant to weigh in on this. Why is that so, considering the technology has been around for a while?
Well, the research is really relatively new. There's probably, for the audiovisual entrainment devices, there's a handful of controlled studies so far. They're all very positive, but before something becomes conventional, and is picked up by the main health authorities, it's going to have to be really proven in research. And it's going to take quite a while for that to actually happen. And meantime, you know, there's a lot of research going on around the medications. And this is also the physician's focus.
So the debate is still ongoing.
Yeah. Yes.